Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. Working on site can be a pretty dangerous job. With people and machinery moving around, it's really important to routinely look around for hazards in your work area and take action to make sure that the site remains a safe working environment for you and your team. So in this video, we're going to look at how you can record, track, and action hazards that you observe on your worksite using Dashpivot. So you can see that we've got a hazard reporting workflow template already set up and good to go. It's been set up as a workflow, so there's three columns. And what that means is if I was to click this green button and add a hazard, the hazard form would actually sit in this first column. And then as we sign it off, it's going to move from the first column to the second and then finally to the third. So I'll show you how that works. If I click the Add Hazard button, you'll see that we've already set up our template. So we've got a series of fields here. We've got some drop downs at the top. So I'm going to start to fill this out. Maybe this hazard is in zone two. The company involved might be this top one. We can select the risk level based on this risk matrix that we've got set up just below. So in this case, maybe the hazard is low. And we can proceed to fill out all of these fields. We've got a section for date, we can add a description of the hazard, and what's really handy is we've got a section for photos. So if you're filling this out on your phone, you can open up the form, you click the Add Photos button, it'll open up the camera, and then you can take a photo and then save it so that it gets added to this particular form as you're going out on site. You can add, we've got a table here for immediate actions. Maybe there's several actions that need to be filled out and we can add photos for those as well. And then we've got a section at the bottom here, but I'll come back to this in just a moment. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to save this form without signing it off. And you'll see that it sits in this very first column, so hazard identification. I deliberately didn't fill out the bottom because if we were to sign this form, it's actually going to move from this first column to the second and eventually to the third as well. So I'll show you how that works. If I open up this form, at the bottom we've got two signatures. So you can see the green buttons here. And they both tell us that if we sign, it's actually going to move this hazard, this hazard report form, to the next column. So it tells us this. And because we've got three columns in our workflow, we've got two of these approval signatures set up. But the catch is that although we've got two signatures, one is actually disabled. So the second one is disabled. And the reason for that is that you need to sign off these signatures in sequence. So we can't sign off the second signature until the first one has been signed. So I'll show you what I mean. If I click sign, it's going to stamp my signature with the time and date. And it's actually, because it's set up as a workflow, it's actually going to lock all of these fields above. So it can't make any changes anymore to the information that we've already entered. But below the signature, everything below this blue line here can still be changed. And because we've signed off the first signature, the second signature field has now become enabled. But I'm not going to sign it off just yet. Because if I save the form, after I've signed the first signature, if I save the form, you'll see that it's now sitting in this second column for rectification review. Now, what's really handy about the workflows inside of Dashpivot is that we can set up notifications so that for any of these columns here, if we want someone to get notified every single time a form moves into a certain column, we can do that automatically. And we can use our notification tools up the top here to select either someone from the team. So these are the people who have access to this team. Maybe in this case, Nick, maybe he's the general foreman. We want to select Nick to receive a notification each time a hazard is ready for a review. So we've gone ahead and set that up. The other icon that we have here is the bell. And the bell is actually to notify yourself and your account each time a form moves into this column. So if I, as Sam, logged in, want to receive a notification, I'm just going to click this bell, and it tells me that I'm going to receive an email notification every time a form moves into this column. So I'll get an email with a link. I can open it up inside of Dashpivot, and then I can open up the form, review the information, add in some extra comments, And once I'm happy with that, I can click sign and it'll stamp my signature. And if I save it, you'll see that it's now moved to the closed column. So it's moved all the way through our workflow. Now, over time, you might end up with something that looks a little more like this, where you've got multiple forms running through your workflow, each at different stages. And what's really handy about Dashpivot is the ability to convert all of this workflow information into a register. So with the click of a button, we can click register up the top here, and it's going to convert all of our forms into a register, with each column being one of those fields that we had inside the form. So we had a field for the location, we had a field for photos, a field for descriptions, and so on. And you can see that we've got all of those here now in our register. And this is really handy because maybe we want to sort for all of the hazards in zone one, as an example, and we can run that filter through Dashpivot. So we can say, show me all of the hazards that were recorded in zone one. And maybe we want to apply a date filter as well and look at only the hazards from the current month. As an example, we can apply multiple hazards at once. And then once we're happy with that, it'll return the results. And let's say that we need to print this out and give it to someone out on site. We can make a selection over here by either individually selecting or selecting this select all button at the top. It'll make the selection. And then we've got our exporting options up the top here, so we can export to a PDF if we need to, and if we want to print it out and hand it to someone. The alternative is actually if we open up one of these forms, we've got a send as PDF option. So we can click this send as PDF button at the very top. We can click that button and it'll give us the option to enter someone's email address. So we can type in their email and they'll get a PDF version of this form. That's essentially how the hazard report workflow works inside of Dashpivot. If you want to get started with this exact template, if you go to the template section and click add new template, you'll see that there's a button called choose from free public template library. If you click on that, it'll pull up, I guess we've got a couple hundred templates in here now, but if you type for hazard, you'll see that we've got hazard reporting workflow. So you can click on that and add it to your team if you need to. If you need help, we do have a help section built into Dashpivot to answer any questions around the workflows and the notifications and things like that. So you can access that by clicking this button up here, this question mark, and you can run a search. So maybe search for workflow. How do I set up a workflow? We've got an article and a couple of videos and things like that to help you through the process. But if you get stuck on something and you want to ask us a question, we've also got a live chat button down the bottom here, and you can send a message to myself and the rest of the team here at SiteMate. And that's basically how you can record, track, and action hazards using Dashpivot to keep your worksite safe. I hope this has been useful, and thanks for watching.